Dire team ban. Radiant team pick.
Lone druid.
Dire team pick.
Luna.
Dire team pick.
Slada.
Radiant team pick.
Shadow demon.
Radiant team ban. Dire team ban. Radiant team ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Dire team pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Vengeful spirit.
Radiant team pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Lena.
Dire team pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Imba spirit.
Radiant team pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Ten seconds remaining.
Terror Blade.
Dire Team Ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Radiant Team Ban.
Yeah, I'm fine. Let's skip the intro. Let's go straight to the picks because we're a little bit late. So, Shadow Demon, Terrorblade on the Team Spirit side. Always fun to watch all those mass illusions. What do you think about that?
I think it's strong. To me, you know, if the Luna gets taken out, you obviously want to be able to deny that Shadow Demon from him. Makes a lot of sense to also pair it together with somebody that can take advantage of it. The interesting thing to me is this Lina. It feels like already a really strong roaming support with the Shadow Demon, but you still need an offlaner, I'm assuming now.
Yeah, that is correct. Shadow Demon and Lina are going to be roaming around. Pretty strong duo. Disruption into Lina's stun. Pretty deadly.
And then, meanwhile, on the side of effect, they were able to pick up the Ember Spirit. We did end up getting to see the Slardar also. So, getting taken, I guess that they are going to be running the Lone Druid mid. That makes a lot more sense. But then it's the Puck in the offlane. Do you feel like there's a pretty good hero for it?
If it's Puck offlane, I'm not a big fan of Puck offlane. Maybe if he has a draw in his... lineup to boost him some damage, but otherwise I don't find hero that strong in an offlane.
Yeah, it seems like it could be pretty interesting. We're also just going to mention real quickly that this is in fact the lower bracket finals right now. Effect facing off against Team Spirit. The winner of this one is going to be able to move on and face off against Empire for the final shot into DAC. We have all of the other teams that have been able to qualify so far. NP just qualified the other day. Obviously a bunch of teams from the China qualifiers that happened earlier. So a lot on the line for these teams. Does Effect take the last pick, Batrider? Do you like this?
Batrider, I was thinking more of Legion Commander because of all the illusions from Shadow Demon and Terror Blade, so he can just clear the whole wave with overwhelming odds, but I guess Batrider will do as well. They have Bouncing, Slaughter Stun, Ember Spirit, Magic Damage is going to be enough to deal with those illusions probably.
Alright, well, we're going to hop right into the game. No fuss, no muss. We're making it happen. It is Effect facing off against Team Spirit.
Just
a Monday. To see some awesome Dota, because of the mistakes that happened in the start, so we can redeem ourselves.
That's what's up. I'm liking it. Vanscore, he's going to place down one of these wards, a little bit of a sentry one as well. He's going to run into Roger and signal to them where these wards are. A couple pings come out. Our Zeke has one sentry ward, which Maybe you can get both.
We'll see. Lina, no items besides Tango. Shadow Demon also saving up to buy. He just dropped a courier and he'll bring items. Interesting build on Puck though. 8 Tangos, 4 Branches, and Fairy Fire. Not often that we see an item build on an offlane. He just wants to survive and have as much possible damage as he can and HP from those branches.
Yeah, so what's sort of the role of this offlane Puck? Is it, is there any difference really between that and the mid Puck in terms of your item build or the way that you try and play your early game?
Well, his item's gonna come in later than the mid one, obviously, but he's still gonna do the same in the mid game. If he gets his Blink Dagger up, maybe some good rotations from Shadow Demon and Lina, he can get some easy kills on top.
Okay, Phobos, in the meantime, is going to place down a Sentry Ward, get the D Ward, but also place it within view of the other Sentry Ward, so a little bit awkward there. That might have saved his Observer Ward, though. They might not realize that he got spotted or something. I don't know. So.
Yep. Lina already pinging out where the Slardar is standing. Maybe he saw him, but I don't think he did. It's just a common place to be when you have two stuns with Venge and Slardar. There he is.
DK Phobos can just jaunt away, not going to be in too much trouble. It does feel, though, like right now it's going to be a fairly static one-on-one matchup in the mid lane. So how do you feel about this, the Lone Druid facing off against the Ember Spear? Is one side more favored than the other in your eyes?
Yeah, Lone Druid is stronger, he's going to farm more. He has that extra unit available. He's going to get Orb of Venom, first item, just to harass as much as he can the Ember Spirit.
Okay. Flame Guard might be something that's a little bit difficult to deal with as well, I guess, at least to break through it, but that bear is super tanky and probably not going to drop too easily. We did see over here as well, a Batrider in the offlane took a bit of damage and had to TP back over towards the shrine, I believe, where he healed up again, but we haven't really seen the full power yet of the combination with Lina, Shadow Demon, and Metamorphosis coming out to find the kill at the very least.
Yeah, Vetrider's gonna have a hard time getting some XP. The wave's gonna start to push right now for the Team Spirit. Oh, 9 stacks on Lina. He's not even
moving.
Yeah,
that's terrifying.
10 stacks.
That was actually him trying to move right away. It doesn't move at all. It's terrible. He didn't end up losing in there. So that's a little bit frustrating, I'm sure. Meanwhile, over to the side here, DK Phobos getting chased around, making good use of that jaunt to make sure that he can stay alive, but still stuck at level 1. It's a hard life for a Puck right now.
Yeah, he's still level 1. I mean, it's hard to play against Slardar and Avenge plus Luna, who's gonna control the lane, but seems like it's they will need to pull to get the lane back, actually, on the top.
Oh, that's a good point. Yeah, they do end up getting that pull off now, and well, Equilibrium should even out in just a second. They do manage to pull back one of the range creeps. That's going to be a double, maybe making this a little bit more tough. Although they did get one of the melees over there.
Yeah, nice play by DK Phobos, actually. He dodged the stun from Venge Spirit, and he didn't even have a phase shift there, so just dodged it with Illusory Orb.
This might end up being at least a first couple of levels here for him, as it looks like this wave is going to push slightly, and they're not going to get the full pull off, at least on the second one. But Phobos still taking a lot of damage from Sadoi, who's just not afraid at all to push him out. And that kind of feels to be the story of this lane so far. Batrider getting more out of the offlane than able to.
Well, Batrider is 0-0 and Puck is 1-1 in terms of CS, and they're both level 2, so it's pretty even.
Okay.
Oh, there's the rotation coming out, as I mentioned, on the top lane. Lina and the Shadow Demon just smoking up.
You mentioned that level 2 doesn't take Waning Rift, still the points into phase shift, but they can get aggressive here if they want to. Batrider has backed out of the lane as well, so they might not realize that nobody is showing. Are Zeke going to try and chase? There's going to be the initiation. Now they do have the follow-up stun, connects, a couple right clicks, the orb as well, and that is going to be first blood. FNG draws it.
Yeah, good rotation. That's what you need to do when you have heroes like Shadow Demon Luna, Shadow Demon Kanka, whatever, something that does well together.
Well, oh, in mid lane, Afroninj, he's taking some damage. Oh, dropped very low, but able to get that Fairy Fire staying alive.
He's going for the bottom rune, but rune is actually top.
Invisibility.
Mm. Yeah, that's a nice rune to pick up.
So, do you envisage that they're going to keep the Shadow Demon and Lina up here? Or is this going to be a situation where they have to come back and help out BZZ continuously?
And then BZZ needs help. Lina already TP'd. He needs at least one hero to be on the bottom. Can't stand against a Batrider because he's going to get so much levels and farm and experience.
Okay. Looks like so far, Lone Druid, you mentioned how strong this lane could be for him. It's definitely doing that now to the tune of 28 and 12 to the 15 and 1. It's been quite a tough one for this Ember Spirit here. And I don't know, do Effect need to start to rotate in heroes to help him out? Or is this something where he just has to sort of deal with the constant harass?
Yeah, Lone Druid is a hard hero to kill on the mid lane because of that Savage Roar, actually double Savage Roar, and hard to gank. He didn't get the skill point in ultimate, but he's still fine. Hard to gank. You need to smoke up with both Venge and Slaughter to actually get a kill on him.
Alright. Well, 5 minutes in so far, we can see that it's, a Team Spirit leading at least, as they've had a good initiation in laning phase, as Phobos gonna throw out another orb, can jaunt forward if he wants to, but just gonna dealt some damage to our Zeke.
Bottom tower is being pinged out by Terrorblade. Seems like they wanna push, but it's gonna be hard to push against a Batrider. He just uses Firefly and kills the creep wave. Not instantly, but it's easy to counter the push with it.
Oh, and they're going to be able to take this D ward as well to the side. So, Apple Ninja on top of them. They're going to create some illusions. There's Jean-Tawai. Vanscore in some trouble now as, they weren't quite able to get into position with the Savage Roar to save.
Luna just hit the level 6. If you check the Luna items, he went for Magic Wand and he was afraid of those rotations from Shadow Demon and Lina, so he bought Infused Raindrop just to be sure that he doesn't die.
Yeah, it's a nifty little build. I like to see these little things picked up by Luna. It's definitely been a hero that we've seen get out of control time and again. Still such a strong just position one carry.
Yeah, one of.
But it looks like there's a wraparound to your bottom a little bit.
They want to make a move. Slaughter from behind with Tranquil Boots, level 2 sprint. He can initiate very easily with that.
All of these wards have been committed up towards the top lane. There's nothing back here to the side. FNG, there's the jump. Sasha there as well. They're going to start to deal the damage. The Light Strike Ray connects. Actually taking a lot of damage. The Batrider forced to back away. Is not going to die from the right clicks from BZZ, but it looks like the gank will also not be successful. Everybody forced out for effect.
Yeah. Ember's kind of struggling to get levels. He's level 5 and Lone Druid is level 7, almost level 8. On the mid lane matchup, Lone Druid doesn't have anything to remove his shield, but he can just out harass him because he has more damage.
Kind of frustrating one indeed. So to me, when I'm seeing this Lone Druid get off to a hot start, nobody really capable of taking him down, I'd be a little bit concerned about maybe the early group up potential that they have with this lineup of him and Terrorblade taking down towers. Does this mean you just need to rush a Blink Dagger on this Batrider and immediately try and gank Lone Druid?
Yeah, well, Batrider, we saw some players, if you have a good start, you can go for drums. It's kind of rare at the moment because it delays your Blink Dagger, but it can also work well. This game, he doesn't have much farm, so he's probably going to go for Blink Dagger straight.
Maybe also try and just deal some more of the picking up an early Roche or something could be the other answer for effect to help them through this, because they are definitely off to a deficit in these early stages, but they have a lot of minus armor, so that's something at least going their way a little bit. Is Iceberg just super, super aggressive in this lane?
Yeah, Iceberg has a good movement speed with Rabbit level 4 and Phase Boots 536 movement speed when the phase is on, so he can just dodge the gank by running.
God, 33 denies for him. The same amount of last hits as the Ember Spirit has. This is just disheartening game for this Ninja Ember Spirit, and feels like they don't really have an answer, honestly. Oh, maybe the smoke play.
The smoke is on top. Let's see what they can do on Luna. Because, oh, he got spotted.
I'm not going to be able to get into range. That would have been another nice kill there, but not going to be able to happen.
Puck decides to go for a Veil, straight Veil, then into Blink Dagger. There's some kind of magic damage. I mean, Puck is only magic damage and Lina as well. The rest is pretty much physical damage.
And we've seen a lot of these TPs, they're ready to rotate if somebody does happen to dive too deep, but feels like that could happen mid. Like, if Iceberg goes really aggressive again on Ember Spirit, could we see, like, a Luna rotation find a kill on him, maybe?
And our Zeke is pinging out something. Maybe they want to go for a smoke.
Okay.
Yeah, there it is.
Okay, they also picked up a creep for this. The Hellbear Smasher is there. They do have the jump forward. Chains going to connect. Iceberg in some trouble. And, well, there it is. They end up finding the kill. Much needed.
Yeah, a bit... well, it's a DD Ember Spirit with Vengeance Aura and Swiftness Aura. He deals so much damage. Plus Luna Aura as well. Not bad. Look how much damage they've done to the tower already.
Yeah, this is great. Any bit that you can get at this point in the game is just fabulous. And the Hellbear Smasher to tank it up the whole time. Slaughter is going to wrap around, so if Team Spirit do want to fight, this could be a tough one for him.
Well, Puck is level 6 now, so you can hold him in place. Terrorblade has a TP as well and the meta ready, so if they try to go, he will TP.
The wraparound is there. Vanscore could be a big crush, though. He actually only able to catch onto the already dead hero, and now, oh, dropping very low. The Luna ends up falling. He talked about that metamorphosis. BZZ, super big, and ends up taking down several. Looks like Apeninja also in trouble. Is going to die. FNG gets alive on nothing. Oh, no.
They only killed Vanscore and lost three heroes. Really good rotation. That's the Puck right there. I mean, he can hold him in place for... Coil duration is 6 seconds. If you break it, it's 1.5 seconds extra stun. So, meanwhile, Terrorblade has so much time to TP and deals so much damage.
That really, really hurts. Yeah, and... Well, Team Spirit already off to a hot start. It feels like they do really well in these lineups that are built around fighting early and just taking dominant control of the map. They think about their Chen pick as well, and it's sort of been a similar story here.
They like to play those heroes that have a lot of push potential, which I personally prefer that kind of Dota to see. Oh, Luna is in an enemy forest.
There's a lot of heroes here for effect, though. They turn it back around onto Iceberg. Gonna be able to at least get the Savage Roar off. Trying to get him away. Not gonna be enough. They find that kill. Vanscore now also in a little bit of trouble. Sadoy is maybe gonna end up taking some damage as he tries to back out away from those illusions that were created. Looks like... But he will be fine. Of effect, as they were able to take two big kills.
Yeah, good rotations from them. Kind of felt kind of... Sloppy play from Lone Druid, from the Savage Roar. Think he had enough time, plus Shadow Demon didn't disrupt him. It could just buy some more time, but that's it. They're already on the bottom lane, but they're being pinged out because Team Spirit saw them actually moving.
Just feels like it's go, go, go time for effect, but they need to maybe be... I mean, is there any chance that we see Spirit try and defend this at all, or is it just all about get the counterplay?
Well, Lina just TP'd out, so they're just gonna pressure the other lanes. Mid tower's gonna fall, and Terrorblade is already on top, gonna try to push that, so they don't need to defend it.
Okay. That was a nice little play there. BZZ left one of his illusions mid, and then Shadow Demon creates some illusions of that as well. So we're getting just the mass illusion strategy that you were talking about. Do you think that Effect have the heroes to deal with that in general, or are they a bit lacking in the split push?
Oh, when the time comes, let's say a 20-minute mark, when it's gonna be level 4 Disruption and Terrorblade with Manta style, they're not gonna have enough any out-push damage against that, so I expect Tier 2 towers to fall really quickly.
Money to burn. And you can see Sidoy down here pressuring as well. Looks like the Blink Dagger's still not quite online for this Batrider. That would be really helpful in defending this tier 2 top, but Spirit do look to be backing, at least for the moment.
Yeah, what's the Shadow Demon experience? Look at it, it has the full circle, but he's not level 6 still.
<Who's that? laughs> Here we go, he'll get it right now. Is this, well, maybe he's just not going to stay within the creep range. Come on, man, get your level 6!
They just
smoke. This could be really helpful in the fight! RZ getting initiated on, Vanscore is there, he's going to be able to get the Prismen off Roger. Oh, good play right there to throw out the Savage Roar. He's not going to be able to walk away from that one. Sashlo is going to drop, RZ dead as well. Killing spree for BZZ. Spirit looking good.
Yeah, Spirit looking strong right now. Meanwhile, Luluna, zero kills. He has a Helm of the Dominator, Dragon Lance. She has a lot of farm, but still, I don't think it's going to be enough. Whenever the Metamorphosis is up, they're just going to keep pushing.
Real problem. And all of these illusions. This was the hero that was really hard to deal with. I remember, I think it was the lead up to TI6 as well, we saw a ton of just Terrorblade, and he did get some nerfs to just illusions in general, but the main reason that he went away was because of Elder Titan. Now that Elder Titan's kind of out of the meta again, he's sort of back.
Yeah, the hero is back. Plus with all those heroes getting high levels, I mean, the carry is getting a lot of levels. I mean, in general, in this patch, you level up faster. So Reflection from Terrorblade scales a lot stronger.
Yeah. So tell me how you're feeling about what Team Spirit are going to be looking to do now. Metamorphosis is down for a little while. Puck, he's building towards that Blink Dagger. Do you need to keep your foot on the gas at all, or is it kind of okay to lighten up a little bit, maybe secure Roshan next?
Yeah, it's going to be around Roshan in the next fight. Probably not going to go until Puck ulti is up and the meta. So if they try to, if Team Effect tries to fight them, so they can fight back with meta. They'll just take it slow, farm up. They're not scared to go into the late game with Terrorblade and Lone Druid.
Okay. Seems reasonable. I'm very curious as to how Effect are going to deal with it, but... Oh, Lina does almost have that ulti off cooldown, trying to go on F1 Ninja. Almost going to be able to chase him down, but not want to jaunt forward for it.
One thing we didn't mention also in the newest patch, Ember Spirit can't use Fire Remnant while he's rooted, for example, from Lone Druid.
Can make a pretty big difference there. Do you think that was enough to nerf him, that with the like reduction in his amplify damage for his level 10 talent?
Yeah, it's enough. You can always build Road of Aethas just to counter him. Into even late game, he has to have one defensive item, for example, either Manta Style or Lincoln Sphere.
Yeah. A tool to teach. KB or something like that, whatever he wants to go for.
Yeah, he's not a BKB hero, but you can go for it if they have a lot of stuff and a lot of magic damage, you can go for it. See, something like we saw Tinker going the day before against Nyx Assassin and all that magic damage, which was pretty awesome choice.
Of course, Mr. Iceberg himself playing the Lone Druid this time has picked up the Maelstrom, and very curious to see if we're going to get to see any more of that performance. That was a really impressive Tinker display to knock Vega out of the tournament.
Yeah, totally agree. Was really impressed. Two Blink Daggers are up on the Team Effect side. They have Slaughter and Batrider, plus Veil completed on Ember Spirit, so they might try to go for something right now. They don't have any smoke. Okay, they actually have one smoke on Slaughter, so they'll try to make a play right now with those Blink Daggers.
So last time we saw a lot of Team Spirit just able to kind of roll over Effect. Is this going to be a similar story in this one, or do you think that now you can like you have a substantial advantage over Team Spirit's lineup?
I think Team Spirit has an upper hand right now. They're so stronger, but Team Effect is in smoke right now. Let's see what they can do. Will they try to find a pickoff?
Fenji is there. They're going to remnant forward, pull him back in. Roger hasn't used his blink dagger as of yet, and it looks like Spirit wisely are going to back off for the moment. BZZ is actually looking for this. He's stepping forward. Yeah. But
this is just one kill for Lina. Using a smoke, Batrider lasso, and showing the Slardar blink, that's really not worth of a kill, actually. Meanwhile, on the top lane, Lone Druid just free farming. They're trying to go for Roche right now, which is not a good choice.
This is a little bit scary. They're going to send in the Terrorblade Illusion, and Factor realizing very rapidly that they are not capable of doing this.
They needed a bigger kill on Lone Druid with that smoke or Terrorblade, so they could have gone for Roche.
Team Spirit now all in the area. Possible that they can take this down pretty easily, or is this also too scary?
Yeah, they'll try to do it. It's going to be a huge fight coming out in the next minute, probably.
All right, Wave of Terror goes down. Going to connect onto two of these heroes. They, I do believe, have spotted the Roger Blink Dagger at this point. They hadn't seen it beforehand.
Yeah, but DK Phobos has a Blink Dagger as well.
Flame Break going in. DK Phobos, there's the initiation. Counterplay now onto Iceberg and FNG. Dude, two-person crush. And, oh, they're trying to take him down. And a ton of damage coming out from that Sadoi Eclipse. But look at the turnaround. Oh, my God, it comes out. They kill off
BZZ.
Our Zeke. Oh, my lordy. BZZ is huge. Take down another.
Well, Luna bought back. They want to fight at the Roche again, even though Eclipse is down.
That was so much damage from BZZ.
BZZ went for a BKB, doesn't have it yet, but feels like he needs to go for it before Manta, because of all that magical damage from Ember Spirit and Sticky Napalm, Luna Eclipse.
Roshan still up. Not look like Team Spirit are comfortable walking in. Eclipse is down. Oh, there is a timing here for the next 86 seconds at least where can walk in and fight potentially.
Yeah, but so is Metamorphosis down as well for the same amount of time.
Okay.
It's kind of a the most important
All right.
spell to
Jump
fight
in
with.
Now. On to Iceberg, Savage Roar, Sadoi not going to be able to chase him down. Roger also going to be controlled, and, well, they do get the Purge Creep off, going to be able to connect. A big Blasso is going to be able to come out. No, never mind. They turn it back around, though. Roger already dead. Arzeke also going to fall. FNG throws out the ulti onto Sadoi. They are going to be able to kill off that Luna. Info Ninja doesn't even hit the chains. A very awkward engagement from Effect. They are not looking incredibly coordinated as Sadoi is going to be
body
chased
block,
down.
Body block,
there
go
as well.
DK.
Yeah, this is tough. Another chains off the mark here for Afroniju. Tried to get away with the Lone Druid. He can just chase him down so effectively. He's gone. Another one goes the other way.
It's time to finish the Roche.
This has felt like a very different Effect team than we've seen previously. And likewise, a Team Spirit team that looks very coordinated.
Yeah, Team Spirit has really good coordination in team fights. If you see the good disruptions coming out, big dream calls on three or even four people, and they fought even without Metamorphosis on cooldown.
Oh, Roshan soon to fall. Metamorphosis is up. Luna had dieback, so she's not going to be able to be here, but does have Eclipse. They go for the jump in and crush.
Probably not. Terrorblade just keeping away so that he can't go in and blink.
They are still in the area. They're going to jump back out. Bring down Iceberg. Okay, Aegis gone. There's the Dream Coil down again. Very low cooldown on that spell, of course. Arzeke taking the damage from the Metamorphosis. Luna is back up now and could be trying to come back into this one. They take down Arzeke, but not a big price to pay for that Aegis.
Yeah, that was a pretty fast Aegis taken down. Lasted only a few seconds.
Double damage. A soldier.
A little bit of a comeback for Effect, but Team Spirit still leading by about 6,000 net worth and 1,000 experience. Bottom lane, FNG is gonna die.
Three
bit
hits.
Of a lucky rune.
Yeah. But still dead though. Batrider was already in the neighborhood, so.
Puck in the top lane. Phobos has definitely been able to rotate and become more of a core as Vanskor is going to die mid lane and able to take him down rather rapidly.
Yeah, but if you look who Team Effect is killing, it's almost every time Shadow Demon or Lina. So these skills doesn't give as much gold and experience to the Team Effect. Meanwhile, Terrorblade still has zero deaths, BKB working towards that Manta style, which is gonna be huge in fights. Ember Spirit has almost... well, Puck has more farm than Ember. That says a lot.
Yeah. There is this nice little core here in the middle where you have Ember, Batrider, and Slaughter that all are relatively farmed. Like, they've got some fighting effectiveness and a little bit of mobility. But it definitely feels like they're the ones that are lacking. If the game goes on, though, can they catch back up? It feels like maybe they continue this out. They've got more cores in the end game.
Both teams have a really strong late game, but Terrorblade is much stronger with Lone Druid against that Luna, even though she has aura from Vengeful Spirit, and but Ember Spirit kind of lacks items. He needed to have at least Boots of Travel plus one more item.
Okay. Also, haven't gotten to see it a ton, but the Terrorblade talent tree is pretty nifty. That last 30 second cooldown, or rather minus 30 second cooldown on Sunder is just absurd.
Yes, it's a 10 second cooldown actually. Yeah. When you're level 25, or you can go for 15 all stats, which is also amazing.
Well, as it stands, we might not even be getting there. BZZ hitting onto the tower, they can throw out these big crushes, the amp damage is all they want, but BZZ doesn't give a damn. He is too hard to bring down, and the illusions, just everything. Another crush. They pull
good
back
lasso.
In Phobos. Okay, trying to turn his back around. The BKB pop for BZZ, though. They're not taking near enough damage. He has the Sunder still, turns it onto Arzeke, so very much survivable. His BKB charges are wearing low now, but they've already used the Eclipse. A big jump in from DK Phobos. The Waning Rift doing a lot of damage, and now they are going to be forced to pop the Shrine. Arzeke still dropping low, but not dead yet. To hold for effect.
Tier 3 tower down, ranged barracks almost down. It's just safe to go back right now. Ember's gonna try to chase, maybe get a kill on Vanskor.
Yeah, nice chat there with the chains. They are gonna be able to get the disruption off, but... Well, unless they can get more, BZZ is amped up. Okay, maybe this is turning into something pretty effective. Roger taking a lot of damage from Phobos, has to jump into the trees, getting chased around by the illusion. We'll keep an eye on him to see if he ends up dropping. Does look like he's going to be able to escape from that one, but they do take down BZZ, so a big kill going back the way of effect.
Yeah, the rest of his team TP'd back. He didn't have a... time to TP because Team Effect has a good chase. Slardar. Oh, there's a fight going on.
A little bit of a misplay now. FNG, they turn to fight this one. I don't know if they completely can't. Iceberg, though, dealing a lot of damage here. He's turning now on Sadoi. They get the Savage Roar as well. Sadoi might end up going down. They do drop the Dream Claw as well. Vanskor shows up. BKB popped, and it isn't going to do the Maelstrom damage, but they will be enough still to find the kill with the ulti and all. Now chasing Soshlo, looking for the kill. Dream Coil is still on cooldown, and well, with no Jaunt forward, they will at least call off the charge.
Yeah, Terrorblade died, but still he had a lot of gold. If you watch how Team Spirit is going for Tier 3 tower, it's really smart if you notice all these little things. Terrorblade is playing aggressive when Disruption is on. He doesn't use it offensively to push. It's just if they try to go on him, he disrupts him, then they have enough time to go back, and they repeat that again.
Really impressive display. So right now, it feels to me a little bit as if Team Spirit, through the laning stage, the way that it started, and Iceberg getting off to a hot start, it just has been him completely taking over the game. Do you think that this was mainly a drafting thing, or do you think that Team Spirit are just playing better than Effect here?
They obviously playing better rotations, even though the score is 17-15, but that Batrider is not doing that much. I was expecting Legion Commander to be the last pick for them to actually clear those illusions easily.
So maybe if they did have that illusion clear.
Yeah, and it would have been easier to deal with Terror Blade or Lone Druid with that blink and just a blade mail.
Well, maybe the answer lies in the high ground defense. It feels like it's kind of the only avenue back into it for them at this stage, and possibly the movement in to take down Roshan as well as it goes on. But you can see now as well, this is a very frustrating strategy. Obviously, no backdoor protection on Shrine, so they can literally just keep sending these Terrorblade illusions in, and it's slowly going to whittle down the shrines.
Yeah, that's actually really big. You can't TP to a shrine, you can't use it to heal. Slaughter is invis.
They're just going to keep doing this. This shrine is going to fall eventually. And they don't have to commit anything for it, really. Oh, Sashlo up front and center is trying to walk away from this one, but the Dream Coil is down. The rest of his team is converging, but they're going to be here far too late. And now Iceberg, smelling blood, looks like they want to take down this shrine as well.
No. Puck has a Yule Scepter now. That's the second Yule Scepter, so they have even more control for all those heroes besides Luna, who has a BKB. And I wonder what Puck is going to go for next. Probably an Aghanim Scepter would be the best choice because of that extra Dream Coil break. Attack. You get coil duration 8 and almost 5 seconds stun duration. Yeah, there it is. He has it already in a quick buy. So if you plant a good coil, Terrorblade is just going to destroy the whole team.
That sounds terrifying. Yule Scepter lift up on the Slardar, so he's not going to be able to get out of there. Ember Spirit jumps out to do a lot of damage to FNG first. Amp damage onto BZZ. Roger. Invis, the Shadow Amulet working to great effect there. And they are going to back out at least for the moment. Swap back in onto the Lone Druid. Iceberg in some trouble. They throw out the stun, but they're able to pull back in. Iceberg again trying to find this kill. They throw out the Eclipse as well. Our Zeke is already dead though, and now another kill onto Iceberg. So it works out pretty well. A triple for Sadoy, and Phobos now also under control. BZZ is going to get out of there. No TP away. And in the meantime, Phobos playing slippery over here to the side. Can jaunt down to the bottom. Doesn't have a blink dagger. Fonia might be able to finish him off here. Yeah, the blink is getting canceled, and that will be a kill. So everybody dies but the Terrorblade.
Yeah, they didn't do it correctly this time, and they were pushing BKB on Terrorblade committed so early. Plus, they didn't have any vision to reveal that Shadow Amulet from Slardar. Actually, he used it twice in a fight. And a good swap coming out for Lone Druid. He had to pop a BKB. He couldn't disrupt him. I
welcome. They do kill off Slardar here. Yeah, I wonder, did they must have just not spotted the Shadow Amulet before they went uphill, I guess. The only way that really makes a lot of sense. Well, otherwise,
you kind of don't expect any big plays coming out from Shadow Amulet. It's not like you ping that item out. It's like you don't want to buy sentries just for that. I mean, but you have to because we just saw how good it is.
And now Team Spirit do have a couple of sentries on their people as well, so shouldn't end up affecting them again as we get one pullback in now. FNG going to take a good bird of damage before the lean ends up going down.
Yeah, meanwhile, Luna has a butterfly ready. Oh, that's huge. Well, as Luna gets bigger and bigger, also Terrorblade's reflection becomes stronger.
That's a good point. Any disruptions from Shadow Demon, too, really can start to turn against effect.
Well, Shadow Demon needs to decide whether he wants to use it on Luna, kind of offensively, or just to save. Have some more illusions for Terrorblade, or just to save people from Lasso and the ones who's being swapped.
Oh, this is so frustrating for Effect. They're going to get scanned out as well. Roshan was really close to up, but passed by an illusion as well. Actually going to find BZZ. He ends up turning onto him, though. They don't decide to go onto the Terrorblade, instead turning onto everybody else in Effect. All grouped up now. They're going to take a ton of damage. Roger already going to drop low. Sadoy as well does manage to get off the Eclipse, and, well, they're going to have to buy back on the Lone Druid. They're able to take down three of Team Spirit. Everybody from Effect still left alive. Sadoy on a triple. Iceberg now also in some trouble. They managed to bring down the Ember Spirit. Can they actually kill him? Oh my god, Iceberg! What?
That Mjolnir proc just killed two of them with it.
All right, well, Sadoi got out.
Well, he was close to dying back because he bought back in the last fight, Lone Druid. Meanwhile, that Luna is getting so huge. Terrorblade kind of didn't attack Slardar in that fight as well. He was standing next to him for a few seconds.
I was wondering, because when I looked at it, it was like the Terrorblade was right there in front of him with nobody around. I felt like they were going to go on him, but they decided to head over to the side and focus everybody else first, which ended up being a great decision for him.
Yeah, but, look at the timing on the both gems. They were bought at the same time, actually. Both teams saying it was enough of your offensive wards, so one bought on Puck, one on the Batrider. Roche is up, being scouted by that Alpha Wolf.
A soldier's fortune.
Still, Roche seems to be the thing to fight around as everybody's set up again. We've seen now a net worth swing back into the favor of Team Effect. 20,000 almost experience. If you're Team Spirit at this point, how worried are you, and do you think that they still hold that advantage? The fight.
I don't think they have any more advantage right now. The game is pretty even. It's just who's gonna play it better.
All right. Well, they get the lasso back onto one, but Sashlo in some trouble. Sadoi trying to get into range where he can get those right clicks out, but at least for now, like, they're gonna be able to bring down FNG. Not a bad start to it. Orbout as well is not gonna end up. He does jaunt forward. Arzika's gonna be silenced. They do bring down that Ventral Spirit. Sadoi turning on a BZD. They manage to find a bash, but he gets the Sunder off. Sadoi forced back and away now. Cannot take this fight when he's this low HP. And it looks like also Phobos trying to bring down Sashlo, but Bonia on top of him as well. They are gonna be able to hit from the high ground. Sadoi making the plays. That is a monster kill for her.
Yeah, they don't have enough damage to deal with Luna right now. She has 2.2k HP. Plus Hurricane Pike to position herself, blacking bar, and most important, that evasion. They got nothing so far on Terrorblade nor Lone Druid.
And they're both building Scotties to try and tank up a little bit. Do you think this is the correct choice?
They need MKB.
Yeah. It's kind of strange that they... I mean, I guess that maybe they were already committed to this earlier, but... be a continuing problem with no great way to deal with the Luna.
Yeah, both of them are going actually for Eye of Skadi, but they actually need one, and they need MKBs on both heroes.
All right, well, scary times ahead. They're taking this Roshan not very quickly, and force back again. Sashlo pulls in one. The disruption is there, but eventually At Iceberg is going to come out. Sadoi trying to turn onto these heroes is manning up against a BZZ, trying to bring them down, but they've lost the Ember Spirit. Now the Eclipse comes out. This is a turnaround they need. It does not get off the Sunder. That is going to be a dead Terrorblade. Vanskor also in trouble. Godlike streak for Sadoi, and now the Ember Spirit, after buying back, wants to try and chase down Phobos, and maybe going to make it happen. The Crush comes out from Roger. Controlled, stunned, and killed. For our Zeke.
What a play from Team Effect. If I was watching closely the Sadoi, what he does, they drop Terrorblade to half HP, and what he does next is just amazing. He goes into Roche Pit to actually be in the Fog of War, and then uses ultimate right there so Terrorblade can't see him, plus he has that extra night vision for himself.
Feels like the movement of Sadoi continuously this game has just been really on point, whether it was attacking from the high ground there, making sure that he's not a good Sunder target, or if he is, he can get out after the fact. He's been playing a great Luna. 14, 4, and 10.
Yeah, I'm surprised he still didn't go for a Manta style yet, just has casual Yasha in his inventory.
Oh, another fight of Bruin. They take down FNG. Arzika's going to end up falling very low, but they swap back in one. BZZ trying to take down Sadoi. That is only the Aegis, though. Maybe looking for more. They get the stun, trying to look for a bash as well. Can they get it? There's a good imprisonment from Vanskor. Now everybody trying to back out and away. Sunder is there. Managed to bring him down before he can get it off. Oh, no. Now Team Spirit in trouble. 60 seconds. No Terrorblade. Iceberg can try and hold on to his best.
That was actually such a bad disruption. He was trying to use Sunder at the time, and he disrupted him, and then he went out of range to do it, and Luna Beam and Ember Spirit just killed him.
Vanskor not getting it. You know, I really like the decision to actually not go Manta for Sudoi, because it just kind of turns into easy disruption illusions for the Shadow Demon if you send in your own illusions, so...
Yeah, that's why he didn't go for it. He needs to get close to actual Luna, and then he's in real trouble if he's close.
Phobos just didn't stand a chance, and now Iceberg getting chains down, and the Mule and the Procs are doing their best, but when a Luna gets in your base, this is when all hell breaks loose.
Plus, the Satanic is on.
This could potentially just be it, honestly. I mean, they have 5 seconds left for the Terrorblade, but this is going to be two lanes of barracks, and FNG is just getting destroyed. All right, BKB turning to fight. Big Crush already killing off one. Maybe a second here as FNG is going to fall. They buy back on the Shadow Demon. Everybody from Effect running away.
Dire's bottom barracks are under attack.
Oh, are they going to take this? They're thinking about it. Amp damage. BZZ, they have the Eclipse out. BKB popped, all right. Maybe Sari. Going to swap them back away. They tried to do it beforehand, but there's the Satanic. A good disruption. So there's a lot of illusions. They're going to be going back towards Sudoi. It doesn't really matter, honestly. Iceberg is trying to do it. The Mjolnir is doing a lot of damage, but it's not enough.
Yeah,
find
it's
the
time.
Kill. Everybody dead.
It's time to call it right now. I mean, go for the next game. This game is over.
What a great display. Heck, they were down so much, almost 10,000 throughout this early stages, and oh, the Luna just got too big.
Yeah, Luna late game is always so hard to play against. He has a BKB and Satanic on, just going straight for the throne.
Here it comes, GG. Benji does finally throw out one of his own, but... Effect taking game one, are you surprised? Are you, this is what you expected? How are you feeling if your team's spirit right now?